Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. This is Summer Desert Kulfi.
It tastes so good that you will make it again and again.
I have made it in three flavors. First is dry fruit kulfi, second is mango kulfi, and third is thandai flavor kulfi. I have picked up three popular summer flavors. You can try it in different flavors too. Let's begin with the recipe. Main ingredient we need here is milk. I have taken 2 liters milk.
We need to use whole milk.
Grounded cardamom 2 teaspoons. Almond, pistachio, cashews, sleeves 1/2 cup. 1 1/2 cup milk powder. 1 cup sugar. I'm using here normal glasses as kulfi molds. You can use aluminium kulfi molds or any shape of vessel, whichever is easily available. Just make sure that it's easy to remove kulfi. That's why I'm using glass material.
Also, I have placed coffee stirrers. You can use wooden sticks or coffee stirrers, whatever is easily available.
Place pan on high heat. Take 1.5 liters of whole milk. Now our job is to keep stirring the milk occasionally so it does not burn at the bottom. While the milk is boiling, we will also prepare instant khoya or mawa from milk powder. Take a pan, place it on medium heat. Take 1.5 cup of milk powder and milk, and now just keep stirring it. Try to break all the lumps. Our goal here is to make it to the dough consistency. It should be very smooth like dough. Keep stirring it so it thickens well. Meanwhile, do not forget the milk. Milk will also start boiling. Our khoya is almost done. Just keep on stirring and scraping the sides on a low flame. For a minute, it will stick together and become like dough-like consistency. Milk has now come to the boiling point. So just turn to low flame and let it boil, let it thicken. We need to condense it. This is how our khoya or mawa looks like when it is done. It's smooth dough consistency. Now we will put khoya in this boiling milk. This step of preparing khoya or mawa is very much important to give grainy like texture to kulfi. That is which makes kulfi different from ice cream. Now keep on mixing khoya in the boiling milk. After khoya is mixed, then we add all sugar. Mix it all together. We need to boil milk till it becomes thick like milkshake consistency. It has also got that grainy texture from khoya or mawa. It's thick enough, and now I'm turning off the heat, let it cool down. After turning off heat, I'm adding cardamom. I still see little lumps from mawa. It has not mixed properly, so I'm using hand blender and blending it again. Scrape all the sides and let it sit. While it is cooling down, it will again thicken a little bit more. After cooling down, I have divided base into three equal parts to add three types of flavors. First, I'm making a dry fruit kulfi base. I'm adding here chopped dry fruits. Mix it all together with spoon. Next, I'm adding saffron. This step is optional. It enhances the flavor of dry fruit kulfi. Just take a little bit warm milk, add saffron to it. Warm milk will add more color to saffron and you will see the true color of saffron. Mix it to kulfi base. Now second, I am adding mango flavor. 1/2 cup mango pulp, mix it to kulfi base. Here I have selected these three flavors. First is dry fruit, second is mango, and third I am preparing is thandai flavor. I have taken 1/4 cup thandai powder and added to kulfi base. You can mix and match flavors. You can also make chocolate kulfi or whatever flavors you like, you can add it to the base, whatever is handy and available. Our thandai kulfi base is ready. Now we fill up all the molds. Also, if you don't want to add any flavors, you can just fill up molds with just the kulfi base. That's also fine. I'm filling up all the glasses in the same way. Just keep little space on the top. Do not overflow it. All 6 molds are ready with 3 types of flavors. Now wrap the molds with cling wrap. Wrap it tightly. Cling wrap is necessary so that you can poke the stick inside and it will stand straight. Now we reach to the final stage of freezing. Freeze it overnight. This is how it looks after freezing. Once you take kulfi molds out of freezer, let it sit at room temperature for 2-3 minutes. Within that 2-3 minutes, we need to follow one procedure to remove kulfi properly. In one bowl, take some lukewarm water. It should not be too hot. We do not have to liquefy all the kulfis, so make sure it's not hot, or you can even take at room temperature instead of lukewarm. Lukewarm water means 36 degrees Celsius or 98 Fahrenheit, which means you can easily dip your finger without hurting your finger. Now remove the cling wrap nicely. Place the mold in lukewarm water. Idea is just to warm up these edges which are frozen completely. For upper portion of the mold, I'm just scrubbing it with my hands to give some warmth. Since it's overnight freezing, so it will take little bit time for edges to melt. Do not liquefy it completely. At every stage, just see how much it is required to dip in lukewarm water. This is how it looks. I'm repeating the process for other molds as well. I just love to see it when it comes out correctly. It's so yummy. I hope you guys like my video as much as I love making it. Show your love by clicking on like button, sharing it with your friends and family. Do pour in your comments. Thank you.